Hello everyone and welcome back. My name is Natalia and on this channel we focus a lot on personal and career growth, specifically how we can improve those areas by skills. And today we're going to talk about more of an emotional intelligence skill. Now, emotional intelligence has many layers to it, which we will dive into later on this channel, but today I want to specifically talk about our self-talk. Now, some of y'all will question, hey Natalia, self-talk is not a skill, but it is. The way that we speak to ourselves can really reflect what's going on in our heart, in our mind, and so on. It can be a reflection of the environment that we are currently in. So remember that words are very powerful, especially the ones that we tell ourselves. And today I want to really focus on one specific word that can change the way that you see something. It can change your perspective. But before we get into that, I want you to think of a moment where you told yourself that you can't do something. A lot of times we will phrase things as, I can't do that. I don't know how to do that. I don't have that skill, and make up a list of I can'ts and I don'ts. Why is it that we think so many things are unreachable for us? When we're encouraging friends or family members or loved ones, we might be 100% in telling them like, yes, you can do it. But why is it that when we reflect onto us, it might be a little bit more difficult to say those words? Instead, we come up with the I can'ts and I don'ts. Sometimes those I can'ts and I don'ts are in the subtext of excuses. Oh, I don't really have time today. Oh, I just don't like to cook. That was one I used to use a lot. These excuses might be a defense mechanism for us because we might be afraid that we really can't do something. But I'm here to tell you that skills, cooking skills, to thinking skills, to emotional intelligence skills, are all abilities you can learn and you can develop. So today, I want you to focus on the power of the word yet. So instead of saying, I can't do this or I don't have this skill, add the word yet to the ends of these sentences. I can't do this yet. I don't have this skill yet. The word yet now frees you from the pressure of having to know how to do it at this very moment. A lot of our fear and our concerns when we might not know how to do something, because we might not, is the fact that we never will be able to, but that is entirely not true. There is time, there is methods, strategies for you to learn something today. And if not today, soon, whatever that time frame might look like for you. The word yet tells you that it's not that you can't or you're not capable. It's that you haven't learned it yet, and that is no problem. Communication skills, emotional intelligence skills, critical thinking, creative thinking, design thinking, so many on the list of skills, cooking skills, drawing skills. There's so many out in the world that you can continue to improve on. Continuous improvement is so important. We are not meant to learn something and stay at that level. There's always going to be something better to search for, to go for, to learn. So I want you to focus on the power of the word yet this year. And stop telling yourself that you can't. If you don't know how at this moment, find a way. There is always options. Remember, there is time. There truly is, even in moments where it doesn't feel like it. There is time for you to get what you want, to learn how to do something. You just have to start today. It's scary, it's concerning, it's uncomfortable. But I promise once you get more comfortable in the skills that you might not have a strength in at this moment, it will get better. For example, recording YouTube videos is not my strength. And I remember the first time I did it, I told myself these words, like, I can't do this. Like, I don't have the right skills. And I'm not the best at it, but I'm trying. I am learning. And a year from now, if I have continued this, I'm sure they will be a lot better. It's about improvement, not perfection. So I hope that you focus on the power of the word yet this year and give yourself a chance to develop. Develop anything it is that you want to. I truly believe that you can, and I will be here to help you along the way. We will learn different skills, dive into different perspectives from them, on this channel this year, and I hope that it will help you turn that I can't to I can. I hope you learned some positive self-talk today and you put it into practice because you deserve it. I hope you stay safe, and I'll see you in the next one.